So I spend a lot of time working on highly customized WordPress websites, and something that has been annoying me lately is that every time I go to look at the list of pages, they're always in alphabetical order, and this is not particularly useful to me. This is in the admin view, and these are pages. They're not posts, they're pages, so they're just like outside of the sort of blog post world, even though they're implemented the same way. So it sort of makes sense that they're alphabetical by default, but generally speaking, what I want to do is I want to edit one of the last few pages that I edited, and that's not the first ones that come up. This is one of those little problems that's, A, it's not essential. It's not part of a feature that I'm trying to deliver. It's just an annoyance. And B, it's in an area that's outside of my usual programming context, so I'd have to do a fair amount of research just to figure out what are the APIs involved just to fix this. And, I would normally do a bunch of Googling, but it seems like this kind of problem is pretty well suited to the kind of coding that ChatGPT can help with. So I thought that we might have a little conversation with ChatGPT here and see if we can come up with a quick fix for this in less time than it would take me to do the research and do the debugging myself. We'll probably still have to do some debugging. Okay, so what I'm going to say, let's see. I'm going to phrase it this way. I'm going to say, write me a WordPress filter. No, I'm going to start with plugin. I'm going to pretend that I don't already know that this needs to be a filter. So I'm going to say, write me a WordPress plugin that makes the admin page list sorted by reverse chronological order by default. All right, let's see what this comes up with. Full disclosure, I have actually already gone through this process, but with GPT 3.5, I haven't done it with 4 yet. Okay, so this is already a little different. All right, so it's got a lot of instructions here for how to actually make this into a plugin and put it on a site as a plugin, which is actually kind of cool because, it's not certain that I would know all that. Actually, I already have a site-specific plugin. I'm just going to grab this code here, and we're going to plop it in, and we're going to see if that works. And it actually works on the first try. And I will say this is better already than GPT 3.5, because 3.5 we had to have a long conversation before we got this far. That said, as a human programmer who knows a little bit about this problem, I think there might be something missing here. So, okay. I do want to, before I dive into what's missing, let's talk about what's cool about this. First off, we've got this add action to pre-get posts. One of the first things I would have had to do myself, if I had written this from scratch, is I would have had to figure out, okay, what is the hook that we have to hook into? WordPress is full of hooks. You can modify everything with hooks, but you have to know the right one, and sometimes that takes some research. It has figured out the right hook for me, and clearly it works. So this is the hook. This hook gets fired before fetching posts, and it receives the current query that's going to be used to fetch posts. And what we're doing here, so this is another thing that it has figured out for me, is what are the arguments that this callback needs? Great, I don't have to think about that. I will, if I need to customize this, I will have to look up what API the query object supports. But I don't have to figure out what parameters to give this function. Okay, we're checking is admin. This is another thing that I actually didn't know worked until I had a previous conversation with GPT, and then I looked it up, and sure enough, it's the correct function for this. This is basically saying, are we on the admin screen? Or one of the admin screens, one of many. And then here we're saying, is this the main query? And this is a real thing as well. I believe what this says is this like the main query of the page rather than some subquery of like a widget somewhere that also lists posts? I think that's what that's about. And then what we're doing is we're checking these standard globals This is really nice. This is saying make sure that there is an explicit order set here. Because, okay, let's go real quick over here. If I click on title here, what's going to happen is up here in the address bar, now we have an explicit order by and order parameter in the URL. So that overrides. And this check here makes sure that it overrides rather than always forcing this into reverse chronicle order, which is great. And it is correctly using isSet. That's good. And it's setting the order by and the order attributes on the query before that query is actually executed. Once again, I would have had to look this up. I didn't have to look it up. It works clearly, so it's the correct code. What is missing here? There is absolutely nothing here to make sure that this is only applied to lists of pages. This could be applied to lists of other things, and just some inside baseball in WordPress, everything is a post, like everything is a post. And pages are posts, and posts are posts, and sometimes other things that you wouldn't expect are posts. So this is gonna get applied to like every single listing of like content entities in WordPress, and that's not so great. So let's go back to GPT. And let's see, how do we want to phrase this? Only apply the filter when we're on the pages list. Let's see if that works. I really like that it's not trying to rewrite the whole file, it's just rewriting the function in question here, or just showing the rewritten part. I guess I could just hit copy code. All right, let's go over here, replace the function. Actually, you know what? Let's keep this here and put this underneath it. I just want to check this over real quick. And the reason I want to check this over real quick is one thing I have run into already with ChatGPT is that sometimes you'll ask it to make a change and it will change the thing you asked it to, but then it'll also make some other unrelated change to the code, which breaks it. And, you know, that just kind of highlights the fact that ultimately it is an autocomplete engine. It is not a refactoring engine. It tries really hard to pretend to be a refactoring engine, but it doesn't actually understand the code. And, you know, the next run through can totally regenerate it in a different way. This looks pretty much the same except for what it added. I don't think that's right, actually. Let's go ahead and, okay, this is the old version. I'm going to get rid of that. Okay, no, it is working. Screen ID equals edit page. I haven't actually seen this version before, and it's not exactly what I expected. So, in a previous conversation, we came up with, what did we come up with? Yeah. Screen base is edit and screen post type is page. And that makes sense to me. And I guess ID kind of puts those together. I wonder if this plugin will actually show me that. Ah, okay. So this is great. This is a tool for WordPress called Query Monitor. Admin screen, base is edit, ID is edit page, post type is page. Well, we could always ask ChatGPT about that, what it used there. Tell me about the WordPress screen ID property. Blah, blah, blah. So I'm starting to believe that this is actually a workable approach, but just for fun, I am going to ask it to rewrite it to a slightly different form that I'm more familiar with. Rewrite filter to use screen base and post type to check whether we're on the pages list. Who knows? Maybe that'll work. Okay, well, it figured out that we mean that in place of screen ID, which is kind of cool. All right, let's try that out. All right, is admin is main query, base is edit, post type is page, the other stuff looks the same. And coming back here, let's go ahead and make sure it's a full reload. Yeah, it does seem to be working. So there we go. There's the filter that we needed. We had to have a little bit of a conversation about it, but we wound up with what we needed in the end, and it was really fast to get there. Much faster than it would have taken me to do the research and go through a few iterations until I built up to the code that we have here. This is what I think of as a boring problem, and I think ChatGPT is already really great for these kinds of boring problems. This is something that represents, you know, not a needed, a ticket that we have to implement. It's just friction. It's just a little bit of friction. You know, it would feel really low leverage for me to go do all of the research to figure out how to do this. But if I can get like 95% of the way there and do a little bit of tweaking and I'm there and it does basically all of the API research for me, I mean, that's a win. I hope you enjoy this little exploration of doing boring coding chores with ChatGPT. If you enjoy content like this, please do give us a follow. And also check us out at graceful.dev, because that's where all the good stuff is. And I think I'll be publishing some more videos on coding with ChatGPT on that site. And finally, I believe that for YouTube, I'm supposed to have some sort of exaggerated facial expression for like the screen cap, the cover image of the video. So I better just like do a couple of those. So let's see, how about, all right, that should do it. Thanks again for watching.